Good afternoon. When Urbandale paramedics rushed to little Eli Dobbs' house Saturday, they knew he'd been run over by a truck.
What they didn't know was who was behind the wheel or how a four-year-old whose little helmet was shattered could possibly survive. To a four-year-old.
Four and a half.
Okay, four and a half-year-old. There's independence and speed.
Because you can go faster.
In two wheels.
Just within the last month, he's taken his training wheels off, so he's been riding a lot.
And the cul-de-sac rule, a helmet every time.
So you don't fall off and bonk your head.
But this is helmet number two. The first,
it broke.
How'd it break?
When the truck ran over me.
It happened Saturday in a neighbor's driveway.
As I turn around, I see a truck with no one that I can see driving, rolling back over, looked like about to roll over three boys.
Including Eli.
And I was screaming, stop, stop.
I saw the tire go up over his bike and saw him under the truck as well.
This ran over my helmet and me.
There was a two-year-old inside that must have somehow put it into gear.
It was scary.
The chin strap was still around his neck with a piece of helmet on it.
Shattered in so many pieces.
Six. Seven. Eight.
Police are convinced the tire crushed it.
We definitely feel like the helmet saved his life. For it to shatter like that, something had to have hit it, whether it was the wheel or something. And if it wouldn't have hit his helmet, it would have hit his head. And that could have been possibly fatal.
Eli has owies.
Right here on this spot.
Plenty of them.
On my forehead and some on my face. And
but after a little bike repair,
kind of got old, but my neighbor fixed it.
And a hospital overnight, Eli came home, clipped on his backup.
You have to put a helmet on.
You do?
Why?
Because so you don't fall off and hit your head.
And triggered tears of thankfulness.
I totally think it's a miracle, and it was God's protection over both him and our neighbors.
No one's quite sure how the two-year-old neighbor kid got into that truck or shifted it into neutral to get it going. The tires just missed those other boys, and Eli's parents are thankful he followed their rule, never ride a bike without a helmet, ever.